I was just watching The Bachelor, and look at what just happened.
Hi, I'm Greer. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Greer.
So, I live in New York, and I brought this coffee all the way here. Because we have a long night ahead of us, so you're going to need that energy. You want to have a sip? Be careful. Might be piping hot, just like you.
It's still hot from New York? How does that work?
I don't know.
How do you do that?
I'm magical.
I did think she was going to be lit up, but either way, I do actually feel better. I brought you your coffee.
I'm sorry, who are you?
What?
This is, I'm clearly working.
You, what are you doing?
This isn't a good time, but thank you.
All right, sure. Okay.
Pre-grain with me for Super Bowl 57. So obviously the first thing I do is start with breakfast. Now I'm a huge Quaker Oats guy. Huge. Everyone says it about me.
True.
Hear that? Now I'm just kind of unique in the way that I just like eat them from the tin. I'm raw, I'm real. Oh my god, yum.
There's
nothing like it.
Now, most people make really good oatmeal, and I love that for them, but I'm famously not like the other girls.
Anyway, Quaker Oats is giving you the opportunity to go to Super Bowl 58. All you have to do is show us how you pre-grain.
And you could go yourself.
Here are the details. Read them. I'll wait. Okay, now I have to get dressed. I'm not exactly sure what you're supposed to wear to a football game, but I feel like these are probably a good start, so I'll see you in a second.
What? What'd you say?
Ally.
Say ally.
Ally.
Yeah.
Can you say?
What?
Gay rights.
Gay rights.
Gay rights.
High five.
Oh. Okay, so I almost went home with someone that you and I both know the night of the Grammys, but I don't think I was going to tell this story, but I think I'm just going to leave names out and tell you anyway. During the Grammys, a lowlife TikToker like me is separated from the like main area with all the artists. So I really didn't get to talk to anyone, and I also didn't really expect to, but what I didn't realize was how many after parties there are. So I end up going to one, and it was just kind of like not the vibe. So then I end up thinking like, okay, I'm just gonna go home. But then while I'm about to go home, my friend texts me and he's like, do you wanna come to this other one where there are like some of the artists and like nominees are here? And I'm like, okay, he's probably playing it up, but like I'll go and check it out and just see what's happening. When I arrive, I realize like he wasn't lying. There are a lot of people that I recognize there. So when I find him, he's talking kind of in like a group of people kind of near the back. many of which I certainly know who they are already. Just kind of like standing like awkwardly kind of behind him, but like to the side of him, because listen, while I may seem like extroverted online or on TikTok, in these social situations, I am the most introverted, socially awkward person ever. But then he starts introducing me to some of these people, some of which I definitely like don't need to be introduced to them. Like I know who they are already. And then one of the guys who I certainly know introduces himself to me. And we end up kind of like sparking a little bit of a convo. The only issue is, like I said, we are kind of like in the back near like some of the speakers. So it is loud where we are. I can barely hear a word this man is saying. I keep having to be like, what? Sometimes I just like pretended to hear him because I was like, I can't keep saying what. Like, I can't even believe I'm even talking to this person. Just pretend that you hear what he's saying. It was also a good excuse to be like, physically close together. And then he is finally like, okay, it's too loud, do you want to go outside? And I'm like, yeah, yeah. Anyway, we eventually go outside, and then he sees more of his friends who he starts talking to. Very popular guy. We start talking about going to another after party. And at this point, internally, I'm like, oh God, I don't know how much longer I'm gonna make it. Like, I flew into LA that morning. But I'm also like, Chris, this once in a fucking lifetime. So then he's like, do you wanna come to this party with us? Then we're probably gonna go back to my place after. And then I really think about it, and I'm like, when you're sober, it is really hard to keep up with people who have other things to like help them keep going. Plus, I'm like, maybe it'll add some like allure if I say like, I have to head home. So I make up a lie, and I'm like, I have something early the next morning, and he's like, when can I see you again? Which I guess is like bare minimum, but I'm like, swoon. Now I still haven't messaged him, and I don't know what to do at this point.
Also, before you get excited, it was not Harry Styles. If someone said, I'm gonna Venmo you $15.50 if I can see your toes,
I don't think I would sell my feet pics.
$100.
Okay, yeah.
Right. So I've had chlamydia 3 times, and the stigma. Today, while I was getting tested, the nurse, who I've seen before, kisses to you, Christina, was like, oh, I haven't seen you in a while. And I was like, yeah, it's been a little dry down there. She starts taking my blood, which proves to be tough because I haven't hydrated. Anyway, she's like, what kind of person do you like? First of all, obsessed that you didn't assume I was a raging homosexual. So I just say I like someone who identifies as a man and identifies as someone who is over 6 feet tall. And that doesn't mean they have to be over 6 feet tall. They just have to have the aura of someone who is, oh, you get it. And she's like, well, you're a catch, so I'm sure you'll find one. Then she's like, okay, well, like doctor-patient confidentiality, I can't really like mention you to my son. I'm like, okay, reel it back. What's his name? Because I know my hacking skills can find this man in a second. As I leave, she tells me his name. And when I find this man on Instagram, I find out that he is the ex of one of the men who has ghosted me this past year. And in their story, they're hanging out. Anyway, she just called me, and I do not have chlamydia this time, so little wins. Just tried flirting with the barista, and it went horribly. Okay, so I ended up going back to the coffee shop, which was a horrible idea. I never said I would, but I wanted to know if he had seen the video. I go in, and I see him. He's already smiling at me. Like I know what the look means. So I just kind of, like, cutely ask. I'm like, have you seen the video? And he goes, yeah, it was cute. It was cute? Those aren't the words I was expecting. Now, once again, I'm caught off guard. I don't know what to say. So I'm pulling out my wallet, and all I can think to say is, period. And as I go, like, period, I drop my wallet on the floor. And as I bend down to get it, I slam my knee against the, like, wall of the counter. So now I'm trying to both grapple with the fact that he called the video cute and make sure I'm still cool and chill while my knee hurts, so I don't make a noise, but my eyes start watering. So when I go to tap my card, I have tears in my eyes, and he's like, you good? Just mumble, like, mm-hmm. Now not only has he rejected me, he's watched me fall to my knees in front of him in pain. The pain of this interaction is no longer just emotional, it's now physical, so goodbye.
I tried recording therapy to see if it would be helpful to watch it back, and this is what happened.
Hi. My New Year's resolution is just to, like, shut up for once.
What does that mean? Oh, are you starting right now? Chris.
It really felt like he was flirting.
Because he asked you how your day was while he was taking your order?
Well, when you say it back like that, then it would solve everything.
Chris, if One Direction got back together, it would not solve everything.
Well, we won't know that unless it happens, so I have started reading again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay, I guess I thought that was more of an accomplishment.
If we keep giving other people's words...
Oh, ew.
What?
No, sorry. I just had an intrusive thought from my past.
A man invited me on a private jet to go on a first date with him. So I'm in Paris for the Hermès show, and honestly, every time I'm in France, I say that as if I come often. This is my second time. But every time I'm in France, the two times, last time I was here, some guy just invited me on his yacht after party and was like, we'll be in Monaco in the morning. You should come. And I'm like, I have a flight out of not an airport in Monaco tomorrow. Anyway, I'm at the show, and this guy who's wearing sunglasses the whole show, so I can't tell if he's really looking over at me, but it seems like he's looking over at me. But then it's confirmed that he was looking at me because he comes up to me after and he's like, is this your first show? And I'm like, how obvious was it? Was it that obvious? Then he's like, what other shows are you doing today? And I'm like, none, I'm tired, as if I was like invited to any more. Then we're kind of like small talking, and very quickly he's like, well, if you're not doing anything tonight, then we should do dinner. And I had actually seen this happen, like literally earlier today, I saw a guy just kind of like go up to a girl that I don't think he knew, and they like eventually made dinner plans. So I was like, maybe this is something that happens here. I think he's hot, but he still hasn't taken off his sunglasses, so like, I don't know. So I kind of like redirect the conversation and like, what have your favorite shows been? Like, where are you from? Which I guess he takes as like, oh, he's interested, because then he's like, please, like, let me take you out to dinner. I'll like show you where I'm from in France. And so I'm thinking like, oh, like where he's from in Paris. And then he's like, yeah, it'll only take us like an hour to get there. And I'm like, an hour? Like, but no, I can't drive an hour. He's like, no, we won't drive, we'll take a plane. And so now I'm laughing, because I'm like, this man is joking. Like, I say, I like, I can't like get a plane ticket right now. Ha ha ha. He's like, no, no, we'll take my plane at Le Bourget. I don't know why I just now decided to give him a French accent, but I guess that's the private airport here in Paris. So at this point, I'm like, you're very sweet, but like, I actually can't, like, I have to stay here with my friends, which is a lie because I'm here alone. So then he's like, well, let me, I'm actually not gonna try to do the French accent. Let me try, can I have your number? Like, in case you change your mind, can I have your number? And I'm like, okay, sure. I mean, I won't, but okay. Anyway, this is his bathroom. It's really, I'm kidding.
I just tried flirting with a barista and it went horribly. I go into the same coffee shop every day. I've been going in every day for the past few weeks and I always see the same guy there. He's always given me really nice vibes, which I thought were flirty, but sometimes I guess people are just nice. You know how sometimes when people are like a little extra nice to you and they like ask you a few questions about your day, that is the bare minimum. I realize that as I'm saying it out of my mouth. Anyway, tonight I'm feeling bold. I don't know what it is. So tonight when he asks me what I want, I say, but like in a joking way, just in case I get rejected, I'm like, you. He just goes like, like it wasn't a particular word, or it was just kind of a noise. He just kind of made a noise and was like, nah. So I don't know how to take this. So I'm like, I throw back still in my jokey, flirty way. I'm like, what do you want? And he's like, a woman. All that comes out of my mouth after that is slay. I say slay, I'm oh slay. And then I walk away. I don't think I'll be going back there, but Jeremy, if you see this, cheers to you.
Does anyone else feel like you and your best friend deserve a show? Like, I'm telling you, we talk like the cameras are already rolling. Like, the podcast is already recording. I swear to God, we're a famous duo, just like no one knows it yet.
I was slash am an alcoholic. Now, I haven't had a drink in 5 years, but I was very active very quickly in my addiction from ages 17 to 19. By the end, I couldn't go to sleep sober. I was drinking alone a lot of the time. And when I got to the rehab, they told me I was close to liver failure at 19. Even with all of that happening, it still wasn't my choice to go to rehab. I had an intervention and my family and closest friends told me that if I did not go to rehab that day, like get on a plane within the hour, that I would lose all of my relationships with them forever and I would have to drop out of school and just find a way to survive on my own. At that point, my addiction had lost me so many of my relationships that I knew I didn't really have any other choice. My phone was taken from me, so I was not able to say goodbye to any of my friends. And by that night, I was in Florida in a detox center getting ready to be processed for rehab, which I would arrive at on October 3rd. Happy Mean Girls Day.
Yes, I went to rehab for an entire year in 2017. And this was a hard rehab. This was a mean rehab. This wasn't like a, we're gonna love you until you love yourself rehab. This was a, you fucked up everything and it's your job to fix it now rehab. If you threatened to leave at any point, you were forced to carry around your packed bags with you everywhere you went for at least 2 weeks. If you didn't clean your apartment well enough, like if your floorboards weren't spotless, you were locked out of your apartment for the rest of the day. It doesn't matter if your food is in there. You have to figure out somewhere else to get food. Not that we had any money. You just had to, like, beg other people who weren't locked out of their apartments to give you food. Your first exercise when you arrive at that rehab is to tell the group you're in the 10 most shameful secrets that you have. And if you weren't sobbing on the floor by number 10, you had to do the exercise again until you were, because you weren't taking the exercise seriously enough. One time someone smuggled a phone in and texted someone on the outside that they were gonna leave. And the next day we walked into group and her texts were printed and put up all around the wall, so she had to look at what she had done for the next, like, 2 weeks. It was all about accountability, and maybe unsurprisingly had, like, the highest sobriety success rate in the country. One of. I don't know if that's real. That's just what we heard. We have so many stories from this place. Let me know if you guys want more. One of the craziest things they did for us at my rehab was they would hold funerals for us while we were still alive. And yes, we had to be there. We had to witness our own funeral. Every few months, we would walk into the clinical's office and all the shades would be down and there would be a closed casket in the middle of the room. And then all of the seats would be set up with an aisle in the middle as if it were a real funeral. Then one by one, your parents who were in town for family workshop had to get up and read the eulogy for their child. They would read it as if we were already dead because they had essentially lost us to addiction already. And yes, this was not a fun thing to go through. This was really hard to watch. Everyone would be sobbing because you would literally be watching parents look their child in the eye and say goodbye to them. And as the person in rehab, you were not allowed to respond. You would have to sit there listening the whole time. And then when the funeral ended, you couldn't even go up to your family because they needed the treatment to be effective. It needed to be like you were dead. This was traumatic. But there is the argument that it was effective because none of us ever wanted our parents to ever have to go through that again, especially for real.
Now, when I got out of rehab, I was jobless, okay? I needed a job. Thankfully, ZipRecruiter helped me with that dilemma.
Not the rehab dilemma, the finding a job dilemma.
ZipRecruiter works as a personal recruiter for those looking for work.
Some of my past jobs, I was a barista in college. I was a busboy when I lived in Florida. I was almost a group fitness instructor in Boston. I mean, I guess I was. I taught one class, but then the world shut down. I never really thrived in my fitness instructor era, but ZipRecruiter helped me with all of those. It took a lot of the work off my plate and identifies jobs that lined up well with my resume, but it also dug deeper than that. It took into account my skills, my experience, what I wanted to do for a job, and it helped me discover jobs I may have not even considered. So now I know if I'm ever looking for a job in the future, ZipRecruiter is the way to slay.
Woo!
As we know, I am always on the go.
Always traveling.
Thankfully, Hilton gives me a home away from home no matter where I travel to.
Let me show you around.
Here's my bedroom, where I stay alone every night. That's a good thing. Come on! This is the balcony. I occasionally scream off of it just to keep everyone on their toes.
Snacks around for me when I get hungry.
So no matter what, Hilton prioritized the stay. Now leave me alone. It's me time.
Get ready with me for the Hermes show in Paris. I need your help. I have two options. Should I wear
this green option
with a little pattern? You have some horses on her. She's looking cute.
Or
this white look.
Now personally, I'm feeling the white because... Sorry.
I got a noise complaint. So, just let me know what you think. I'm super excited. Am I happy to be in Paris? Oui.